Have you played it VR games like the Microsoft Flight Simulator? What if I tell you, you can turn your 360 camera footage like this one into Microsoft Flight Simulator like VR experience inside your Meta Quest 2 or on your phone using YouTube VR app? You can turn your snowboarding footage or your next motorcycle ride 360 videos that was shot on the Insta360 X3 or the GoPro Max into something like this in VR. With GPS stacks overlay, you can show how fast you are going, acceleration, and where you are on the Google Map with your live 360 videos. How cool is that? Let's learn how to do precisely that in this in-depth tutorial. Hey, what's up everybody, it's your boy Hugh here. If you are new to the channel, it will help us a lot if you consider subscribing and hit the bell. In order to have an accurate GPS stacks and data overlay, you need to capture accurate GPS data. GoPro Max, like right here, you don't need to do anything. It comes with GPS data. One huge benefit compared to the Insta360 camera down right here. But the Insta360 X3 or the 1RS 1-inch right here has a new GPS action remote right here, sold separately, which can provide you with more accurate, strong, and reliable GPS data. If you use CoolCam or Theta X, you can pair them with a third-party smartwatch like an Apple Watch to get the same reliable data. Even your heart rate, you just need to sync it in post. For the Insta360 GPS action remote right here, please make sure you have a GPS signal first before filming. It usually takes several minutes to find the GPS data. After that, just click the record button. Extra tips, please make sure the front lens of your camera is pointing forward if possible. For Insta360 camera, you can easily use the free studio software to inject GPS data overlay. If the footage has GPS data, a stack icon will show up right here. You can pick speed, elevation, direction, distance, slope, and route. You are also not only limited to one style. In the latest update, you now have two styles to pick from. The second style is actually really cool for motorsports. You can even go into advanced option right here to set your color, opacity, font sizes, all the good stuff to customize your graphics. But, a huge but, this only work on 2D reframed video, not 360 video. See, when I choose 360 video, the stat icon disappear. Bummer. Don't worry, I will teach you how to do it in VR very soon. Keep watching. For now, we just render the full video. I want to emphasize here, the full video. So do not use a cut marker. I like to render out the full video in ProRes, 5.7K, 30 frames per second, so we are not losing any image quality. If your render look bad, you are probably not using ProRes. Next, we will need a third-party software called Telemetry Data Overlay. This is by far the best software I have tested, with a ton of professional templates for motorsport racing, snowboarding, skiing, to video game-like flight data. To create professional-looking flight data like what you're seeing right here to match a VR video game like in the Microsoft Flight Simulator. This is the only software that is able to do so easily. It is not cheap, but I will try to get a discount code for you guys. I can't promise yet, but I will try. Check the video description down below. For the Insta360 Sphere or my Mavic 3 and 1RS 1-inch 360 combos right here, you don't need the GPS action remote at all. And also, we are not recommended you to use it anyway. You can record regular 2D video inside the drone with video subtitle turns on, as you see right here. The drone will record very, very accurate GPS data. Then you can use visual collapsing or time coding in the telemetry software to ingest the DJI GPS data into your sphere or 1S 1 inch so you can have GPS overlay data on your 360 drone video. See, I told you, you will learn extra tips and tricks to make your 360 video to the next level. If you appreciate my effort, don't forget to subscribe and give this video a big thumb up. After you download the Telemetry Overlay software or the free trial version to follow along, install it and open it. Before importing any video, click the gear icon right here and make sure the Eagle Rectangular VR option is turned on for 360 immersive video. In the default pattern, let's also choose the Eagle Rectangular VR as well. Drop in the 360 video we just rendered from the Insta360 studio. Let the transcode to finish to have a real-time playback. It will have an error message said that the data is not found, which is expected. Now, drop in the front lens INSV file. This is the file with the number 00 in the file name. It will automatically sync the GPS action remote data with your 360 video. You should be seeing a screen like this. It's called cube map. Each size labeled the position without facial distortion. You see, there are already preset gauges inside each square. You can resize them, move them, remove them, or add more gadgets into your video. You just need to make sure you don't put anything on the line like this. This will break the output of the graphic in 360. Here is another tip for you. Even though the gauges and graphic look kind of small in here, they are huge inside VR headset. See here, this is the default size of the VR template. This does not look pretty, and the overlay is blocking the video, which is not what you want. So I will recommend to make everything half the size of the default sizes, and move it in a position that is not blocking your video point of interest. I personally love the Google Map display right here. You can go into setting, enable the path, and pick what type of map you want. I use a hybrid right here, so you see the satellite map and also the direction you are going. You can also add new patterns. I add the ski template right here, remove the gauges that I don't want, and make them way smaller to fit the frame. You also want to put your gauges in the middle of the square, where has the minimum amount of facial distortion. There are so many detail settings to customize the gauges to your liking and make your video look super professional and stand out. The last thing you want is your client to know you did it with the free Insta360 template that everyone and their dogs are using. When you are happy with the result, you can export the whole video to upload onto YouTube in MP4, which I would not recommend. You want to edit them further with your video, like hide and show them dynamically, further resize them, and even animate their position in post. So instead, I will pick the transparent video, encoder use PNG video. You can also use ProRes, but the size is huge and the render speed is slow, so I'm not recommending. Now, let's open up Adobe Premiere Pro. We import the telemetry data and the ProRes video into the timeline. The telemetry data is actually in 8K. We drop in the VR projection effects on both the X3 video and the telemetry data layer. Now, they are all in the same sizes. We are going to adjust the pan to align the center of the video to the center of the telemetry data. There you go, look great. Let's say you don't like the data here blocking me, or you want to show them in only a specific time and then fade them out and fade them away. You can very easy to do so now, since now the video layer and the telemetry layer is in the separate layer. Draw an opacity mask around the gauges you want to hide. Click the invert button to hide them. Now duplicate the data layer. On the new layer, uncheck the invert. Now, these new gadgets are separate. You can fade them in and fade them out as you wish, like so. Very cool. Same idea applied to all the other graphics on the screen. Let me quickly show you how to do it inside DaVinci Resolve 18. Import both the video and the telemetry data layer into Resolve, create a timeline based on the video layer, drop in the telemetry data into the timeline. Resolve 18 does not have a 360 video editing feature yet in the edit page, so I highly recommend use the BorisFX Continuum VR unit to make your life easier. Go to Effects and drop in an adjustment layer, drop in the Continuum BCC VR Reorient on the adjustment layer, pick the preset default with overlay. Now you see the exact cue map we saw in the telemetrics overlay in the eagle rectangular format. Now drop in another BCC VR Reorient effect onto the video layer, open Reorient and enable reorientation. Adjust the pan value to align the video to the front. You can also go back to the adjustment layer, turn off overlay, under Reorient, view mode to preview, make sure you check off the enable reorientation button right here as the adjustment layer is only for preview. Now you can look around just like in Adobe Premiere, toggle VR display. When you are happy and ready to render, just turn off the adjustment layer and go to the explore page and you are ready to go. I admit this tutorial is not for everyone and it is a little bit advanced, but the same techniques I teach you right here is what I did for a US government training facility, NDA, so I can't tell you which exactly. It involved jet, and for some sport team training in VR, also can't tell you which, but it is a big client. Adding optional data overlay is not only making your video look cool like a VR video game, but has a practical reason for training and education. You can easily make thousands of dollars for what I just taught you today. Obviously, you need to put in the practice, but it is well worth your time if making 360 video become one of your business offering. I truly hope you succeed in the immersive filmmaking world, and this is why I will continue to offer valuable knowledge completely free on this YouTube channel. All I'm asking is for you to subscribe if you have not already, hit the notification bell and give this video a thumb up and share it on your social media. Help us to help you to stand out from the crowded video making space and improve your skill as a metaverse filmmaker one video at a time. I hope to see you in the next tutorial or in the metaverse. Ciao.